7 clothing mistakes that make you look cheap. This is not the look we are going for, and unfortunately, we have all done at least one of these mistakes. I have some things I want to showcase for you about how to look your best and how to avoid these mistakes. Because of course I want you to look your absolute best. And welcome to my channel. My name is Karina. I make videos to help women become their best absolute self, whether it is their appearance, from their looks, where they shop, to their mindset, and also money. All of that. I also have the best program where I talk about how to become a million-dollar lady. We cover the basics of how to dress amazing, how to look presentable, how to be a high caliber woman, not just when it comes to appearance, but also when it comes to mindset, building your wealth, finding your true self, and I continue to add on new modules. So you can check it down below or go to intoamillylady.com. So let's discuss these things that make your items look cheap, and please avoid these at all costs because I have tried them unknowingly and they simply do not work. The first thing is when your items are fake, and I'm referring to fake luxury items. Believe it or not, a lot of influencers have fake designer goods, and in photographs it's a lot harder to tell, but in public it's easier, and the trained eye will be able to tell. So save yourself the embarrassment and don't walk out with your fake Chanel bag that you bought from AliExpress or even in countries such as China or Turkey that really have these high-end replicas. Even if they are high-end, a trained eye will still be able to see, and there are minor inconsistencies with these things. Also, it is not good for your kind of attraction and your overall energy, I would say, because you know in your mind that it's fake, and it's also attracting this mentality of imposter syndrome and that you possibly can't afford luxury goods, which is not the case because we are living in a world of abundance. So stick to the real thing or invest in quality, but not necessarily designer, or save your money for that one piece that you truly, truly want, and then wear it and rock it with pride, feel abundant about it, and more will come. The next thing is bad fabric. And I actually have an example with me today that I didn't want to have. I actually purchased this dress. I don't really want to say the brand or anything. I don't think there's a reason to say this specifically, but I will be returning this. As you can see, the tag is still on. But it's this dress, and it looked amazing online, but the fabric of this is not quality. First off, it's velvet. I didn't really know it was velvet when I was purchasing it, but it feels cheap to the touch. When it feels cheap to the touch, that's one thing. Sometimes it could feel cheap to the touch, but maybe from a distance it doesn't look as bad, especially if it's black and I put it over here. But the problem is, when cheap fabric sits on your body, you feel it. And when I put this on, I just felt uncomfortable. It's your body is rubbing on this cheap fabric, and again, you just don't feel good when you wear it. And the whole point is, you want to dress for confidence. You want to dress for success. And wearing something you know that the fabric is just of poor quality, it's not gonna make you feel very good. The third thing is actually also relates to this dress, and that is a bad fit. There is such a thing as dressing for your body shape and looking the best in everything you wear. And unfortunately, this dress is, again, just not it. Also, there's a coloring off of here, and it leaves this residue of a greenish black on your skin, which is not healthy, all the chemicals. But this just is ill-fitting. Specifically, if you find other items and they're not comfortable, or they're scrunching down or scrunching up, that's not a good sign. Actually, something can even be too tight. And when it's too tight and scrunching, that is not flattering. I'm actually a certified image consultant, and we learn a lot about these types of fabrics and how they flatter different bodies. And you really want to make sure that the things you're wearing is flattering, not just the way it looks on a clothing rack, but on your body as well. The fourth thing I'm gonna talk to you about is actually shoes. And here we have the infamous Louis Vuitton you know, the good old Louboutin. But I wish I knew this trick earlier. This one is still in great condition, but shoes that are worn out or getting there can give away so much. If the heel is even slightly scratched, you have to repair it. If this is getting worn down, you have to repair it. If there is the nose is scratched up, you have to repair it. If your shoes are dirty, especially if they're white sneakers or they're being worn for a very long time, do not wear it. It just gives a bad vibe to the entire outfit. As far as the bottom of the shoes, unfortunately, these beauties, the bottom does do this, but I figured out this amazing hack, and I wish I knew it before I got these and my other designer shoes, is that if you can actually get it custom for your shoes, but you can buy 3M tape on Amazon, cut it out to the form of your shoe and stick it on. So then this won't rub off. Isn't that insane? And then you can preserve the bottom soles of your beautiful shoes. And I wish I knew this because they would still be red, but it's okay. So make sure to really not have your shoes completely ruin your outfit. Of course, I couldn't get away without talking about jewelry. And this is the next thing, is cheap, flimsy, fashion jewelry is not very flattering. It's cheap looking to the eye and to the touch. It is very, very obvious. This is white gold, and I love this. It's simple, it's beautiful, it is versatile. You can wear it with anything. And the reason I'm showing you this is because you don't need to get fancy, different jewelry. Like, I know some people have these drawers of all this fashion jewelry. You want to wear the jewelry. You don't want the jewelry to be wearing you. And all this over-accessorizing takes away attention from you, and we don't want that. So something that is a little bit more pricey, or maybe silver plated, gold plated, any of that, even not fully but plated, can really go a long way, because you will feel the quality, everybody could see the quality, and it's more sentimental. That's the thing about jewelry, is really the sentiment aspect of it. All my jewelry actually is sentimental. I don't buy a piece just for a fashion statement. I feel like these are things that can be passed on for generations that actually have meaning. That's why I think investing especially into these things is extremely important and valuable. Two more things. The next one is cinched clothing. This happens a lot in dresses or skirts, and when it has little strings, or I would say kind of stretchy fabric that you can put over your shoulders maybe, or cinch up to make a skirt a different length. And the reason why this is not the best, I mean, there are some exceptions to this, there's exceptions to everything, but just be cautious of these things. The reason for that is it doesn't signal expensive, right, or high end, because things that are expensive and high end are more form-fitting, in the sense of it's made to your body, no matter what body you are. But things that are cinched and stretchy and can be versatile that way, a cheap money-saving hack, that it could fit all body shapes, all body sizes, it just stretches and cinches. And that means it's not custom-made for you, or that it's kind of going for the mass market. That's why those things with extra strings and all of that just doesn't look the best. And the very last thing is trendy pieces. These oftentimes do look very cheesy, and they are going to disappear in 2 to 4 weeks. Right now, the big trend is corsets, and there are brands that do them quite well, I would say. However, for the majority, to me, it just looks so silly. And when somebody wears, let's say, a dress like this, and they just slap on a random corset, which looks like an undergarment to me. It looks very cheap in my opinion. I think there is a right way to wear a corset when it's made to wear as a top for like an evening thing, if it's done in a certain specific way. But wearing it on top of clothes, for example, up on top of a dress when it's made to look like it is an undergarment, which is how they used to be worn back in the day, under the dress, right? It looks strange. And a lot of these fast fashion and trendy pieces are strange because they capture attention. And people say, oh my gosh, what's that? But they're like fleas flocking to every new thing. But if you're original and stick to the classic and the things that always work, that's always gonna make you look very awesome. Granted, don't put your personal style aside or anything like that, but just be conscious of how long will this trend last? This corset thing is gonna go away. Just watch this video a little later and you will see how fast these things go out of style. It's because they keep recirculating these fashion trends to make more of a profit, but it doesn't mean it's a good investment because when you wear it months down the line, you're gonna look weird because no one's wearing those things anymore. So you just put all this money into a trend that is no longer active. That was my last tip. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you want more where to shop, how to shop on a budget for more expensive items, all of that is in my Million Dollar Lady program. You can actually check out the curriculum in the description. And also, I want to say I have a program, how to monetize your passions, how to make money if you're into that as well. Everything is going to be linked down below. I will see you in the next video.